Yeah, hi, this is Sathish Balakrishnan, and I am co-founder of Jumati.in. And I have done my BTech in mechanical engineering from NIT Durgapur, and then started working on a couple of startups in the early part of my career, and then joined the backend operations of Amazon.com, where I met Pradeep, the other co-founder. We started toying this idea for some time, and then that is where we got the inspiration to start Jumati from.
So how did you start Jumati? You told me we want more detailed stories of how.
Yeah, as I said, when we were working with Amazon.com, we thought of having a similar service here in India, and so we started toying this idea and experimenting this idea by selling third party sites like eBay and A1 Books, where the response was tremendous just because of the service that we provided. So we thought we'll do a full-fledged service, and that's how Jumati was born.
So who are your competitors? How do you compare with your competition?
Yeah, the main competitors are Flipkart, Infibeam, and a few others. But yeah, I rate Flipkart and Infibeam as the main competitors. And the difference is the price. We are on the bit lower side, and the service is class.
So what is the meaning of Jumati? How did you come up with the name, and what is the relevance of Jumati as a?
We wanted to have a void name which around which a brand can be built, and our mentors Samir and the team from Morpheus and we discussed internally, brainstormed a lot on the name, and finally chose Samir was throwing up a name, Jumati, and we all kind of convinced with it, and we went ahead with Jumati.
Did you face any difficulties in starting Jumati? Did you find it hard? Was it easy?
Yeah, it was hard, especially when you do the vendor types. Suppliers in India don't understand the e-commerce thing. They don't understand the internet business. So they wanted physical store. They wanted this much of volume to be promised in the next month, and so on and so forth. And that's where we faced the real problem. It took around 9 months to establish the supply chain. It was very hard. And also the legal part, like registering the company registration and all that. It's also pretty hard in India.
That's on the supply side. What about the customer acquisition side? Did you find that hard, or was it?
Yeah, it was also harder. The initial 100 customers were very hard to find. Once we were able to get those 100, word of mouth marketing, which is the best marketing that we have so far, worked well for us, and that brought us more customers.
So what's your current worry? What do you really worry about as far as Jumati?
Yeah, the service part. We want all the packages to be sent and reached on time. That is the only thing that worries about, keeps us worried all the time. We want the service to be class apart, and that is what kind of keeps us worried.
So, what's the real single USP of the whole Jumati product?
Service.
What advice do you have for someone who's starting up in the e-commerce space?
Have a clear idea and be focused on it.
Okay, and any more advice that, from your personal experiences?
Yeah, do the homework before you launch. Be the supply side, be the customer facing side. You have to do your own research and all this stuff. It's pretty tough to establish the supply chain in India, especially.
So how do you deliver such good service? Is it hard, or do you have a model? Is it easy to
The supply chain is kind of seamless now. We've established it in such a way that no order is getting missed every time. So the seamless supply chain is in place, and that is the hardest part to build as far as the e-commerce industry in India is concerned.
How hard was it to get funding, or are you funded? What is the stage? What are the stages you went through?
Yeah, we've got seed funding from the Morpheus. More than the funding, that is the business accelerator program that has excited us to join the Morpheus.
Did you invest any of your own money?
Yes, of course. We have invested around 6 lakh rupees.
So where do you see Jumati going from here? Where's the vision for the
company? Yeah, we want to be in the top 3 in the e-commerce space. Within a year, and be the top one in the next 2-3 years. So that is the immediate target, and we are getting into social shopping. That is something new in India, something first of its kind in India, where people can shop in the Facebook fan page of ours.
So you're launching a social shopping
product? Yeah, we're launching it soon. I mean, in the coming 10 days or so.
So social shopping product?
Yeah.
And that means like people can shop through their Facebook
page? Yeah, people can search, select, buy, pay, get order confirmation, everything within Facebook.
Everything within their Facebook?
Facebook.
So how is this product adding value? I mean, to the whole Jumari
product? No, social shopping is something that is new in India, entirely new in India. There are about 20 million Facebook users who we can immediately target it. Around at least 10% of the internet buyers, so we are targeting that space.
Anybody else doing this?
No, not yet in India.
You'll be the first one pioneering this
yeah.
social shopping product. So what is your current user base revenue? Would you want to disclose any numbers or?
Yeah, the revenue is in the range of 5 lakhs per month average for the last 3 months. And the customer base is growing on steadily. It's currently in the range of 7,500 plus.
Okay, Sathish, so thank you very much. That's about it. We love the social shopping product. We look forward.
Thank you.